See what it is in the title. But first of all, you know, I gotta give a shout out to all of the day one YouTube subscribers. Comment below if you've been following me for the last few years or day one. Definitely appreciate the love and support. We try to provide a great in-hand, first impression, visual, and if it's sneakers, sometimes on feet. But moving towards the holiday season, hold tight. Hopefully we can get some unboxings in. Unboxed tomorrow, maybe some electronics and other things as well. So we got some apparel coming on the way. We got some great sales from Nike on the way. So I'll tell you how I got those sales, promo codes, and all of that. Always when you're looking for deals, search for promo codes when you're ordering online for free shipping. And also check out with Rakuten Swag Bucks. New subscribers, hit the notification bell. In other words, select it, touch it on your mobile device. That way you'll have an alert on your phone, your smartwatch, maybe even your tablet. Now you got the new iPhone 15 Pro Max or the Ultra, as far as the S23 Ultra by Samsung. Or maybe you pre-ordered the Google Pixel 8 Pro, which is on the way. Use those devices to check out the videos. You'll have them in 1080p, 4K, and hopefully 8K coming soon to get that crisp visual. You already see what it is in the title, so with no further ado, let's go ahead and get into this first sneaker. I thought I was actually going to be able to unbox three today, but we're going to unbox two real quick. The third one was the Jordan 8 Playoffs, which I had received the size 8.5, but it was for someone else. So I was only able to take photos and upload them to Instagram. Make sure you're following me on IG if you're not already at p.oastman. But I have my size, but I didn't receive it. And I received it at a different address, so I should be picking up those soon. I know you've probably seen videos or photos, but hopefully you'll still enjoy my video the same as I will. Because it was brief when I unboxed those, just to take some photos, but great quality, and we'll go over it a little bit in depth too. But this first one, I uploaded a snippets video and received them early, about 2 days ago. So I'm going to give y'all the first hand visual in hand, a little bit more in depth, but you can check out the shorts video. If you don't have time to watch this entire video right now, but this is going to be the Air Jordan 1 OG High Retro for Women's Bread, which is going to be the colorway, black and red, and it's satin material, new for 2023 for the women. We got the red box for the women with the Nike and black, Nike and the swoosh and black all around. Typically, with the men's releases, your standard Jordan 1 box is going to be black with the infrared Nike and Nike swoosh. So that way you can tell the difference. Sometimes when you get certain colorways, they'll incorporate trying to sneak them into the box. Sometimes, but usually a standard OG colorways is going to be black and red. Alright, so this is going to be a women's 11 and a half US size, which would convert to a men's size 10. A lot of times they'll have the women's and the men's sizes on here. This time it's only for the ladies. 11 and a half. And this is your little thin, narrow content tag. Jordan 1 Retro High OG, women's air, black, university red, and white. So ladies, if you want to add this box to your walk-in closet or show, underneath your bed, you're going to definitely know which shoe is in there by the cover of the box. Alright, that's your lid. Paper. You get a little handbag sack in black with a screen print Jumpman, Michael Jordan, the basketball. What I didn't notice at first in my first shorts video unboxing was that these did come with extra laces, which normally they do. They just stuff inside of the shoe. Alright, so here's your extra laces in red. Black laces. And you do get a little lace tips are silver, a little Jumpman on them. A nice accent for the women out there. Alright, so the reason why I went with this size is because basically of the color. Just released on the shock drop through Nike, which today we're having a shock drop at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for the OG colorway of the Jordan 12. Cherry, white and red. So be on the lookout for it. Hopefully if I remember, I can definitely try to enter. Alright, so the outsole is going to be the red flat outsole, 1984, 1985 model shoe. Check out the movie Air, how Michael Jordan, his parents, the Nike staff and brand chose him and got him locked in to create and start seeing these iconic shoes that we see thus far with Jordan, Nike brand, and all started back in 1984, 1985. Rookie season, Chicago Bulls. Before that, UNC, University of North Carolina Tar Heels, where Michael Jordan did win a championship. Got drafted to the NBA after that. The rest is history. Iconic shoes that we see to this day, new colorways, new styles and designs by the greatest basketball player of all time. You know, we debate about it, we try to create debates. Maybe there's players before him that he admired with more championships, maybe higher scores in a different basketball game before his era, which the game is different now. But after Michael Jordan, at his age that he happened to be, linked up with the Chicago Bulls, no one has been able to surpass at least the championships anyway. Slam dunk competitions. Alright, so you got some champions for that. All-star MVPs, all-star games, dream team, can't duplicate that, but you do have the USA Olympics. Some championship players for that. 2 3-peats back to back. We already know. So great players out in this game now that we enjoy watching, enjoy following, being fans of. But from the 80s and 90s era, you gotta give it up. Michael Jordan, proof is in the pudding. Check out The Last Dance if you haven't already on Netflix or ESPN. But this one is for the women, based off the bread colorway for men's and leather. We have the satin material, same outsole as usual with the Jordan 1 OG High, the lows and the mids, flat on the heel, Nike in the middle with the swoosh, pivot point on the upper, Balder, if it is, then you got these distinctive star attractions. That way you can see what condition the shoe is in when someone wants to resell theirs, and they said they only wore it once or twice. The upper may be super clean. Take a look at the outsole. It can be dirty, but you don't really want it worn if you're paying a lot. Unless you can't find it, you gotta have it. So you got the red, midsole in white, the mud guard in black, the satin turtle in black. Feel that's good. I can already see one in the light of these with some jet black jeans. Maybe some sort of plaid or flannel up top. For the fellas, you can get away with it too. In the limelight, on the red carpet, for your Instagram photos. Alright, it's black, white, and red Chicago Bulls colorways. A little fancy. I myself prefer the perforation in the toe box area of the head, nubuck, or suede that we'll probably see on the Royal Reimagines for the first time. Maybe the first time, I think they use suede. For that particular colorway, pardon me. All black, swoosh and red, outlined and stitched. The heel in black, wings logo stitched. On the upper, the Air Jordan wings logo, iconic. Your tongue, satin, smooth, slick. Nike Air in the red, Tigress style. And you got your black flat laces. Tips to give it some weight and silver, make it easier when you're lacing your shoes. You could do a lace swap with the red. I guess this black may pop a little bit, or just keep it subtle with the black. On your insole, you're going to have Nike Air. The insole is red with Nike Air and black, and the swoosh in black. So, what type of buyer wants these? If you're a seller, you got a store, you're that reseller that's trying to figure out who to secure these pairs with, of course, the women. And as far as men, someone who's never had the bread before, took L's the last times they released, and they want something. They gotta have their bread color blocking. You know, the bread, also known as the band, where they found Michael Jordan, I think like 10,000 a game, back in 1984, 1985. They wanted to ride these shoes. They went hard. Nighttime, Chicago's Bulls colors. They just wanted to stick with the Chicago. They wasn't ready for these yet. But, you know, it's history, right? If you're that collector that collects Jordan 1s, you want these in the collection. The collector that has all the breads that's been released, the band, all the different variants, the canvas, the lows, the highs, the mids, you'll want these in your collection as well. But keep in mind, these secured for me on the shot drop, so it's still opportunity if you want to wait to the official release date. That way you'll have a shot at these for retail. But there are resellers, sneaker shops, and boutiques that have these on average for $240. I think in my snippets video, I didn't have the amount correct, or I corrected it after I said it. I think I said $250. That's more like the resale price. The retail price was $179 plus tax, plus shipping. I think mine came up to about $191. Always remember, if you order from Nike and you're not satisfied, contact your customer service team on the chat on your mobile device, or maybe call, wait, speak to someone, and you can get a return label emailed to you. You print it off, send them back, get your money back. As far as exchanging sizes, these are sold out, so it's only going to be a refund. Because sometimes when you try to take them to the sneaker shops, they may not show love, right? Or they want to, after shipping and taxes that you pay. So if you can be patient, send them back, get your money back, get it back credited to your account. If not, try to get lucky on the resale and make a profit. 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 50, all of that adds up. Or maybe even put these on ice. Put these in the back of the closet, somewhere secure. Somewhere where the white don't tarnish and turn yellow. And maybe in a few years, these will grow in the resale price. Toss them on eBay, StockX, GOAT, any of those. But you gotta be patient sometimes. These may raise in value if that's what you're looking for after the release date. Individuals may really want these. These are just okay for me. Great touch with the satin. It's just I prefer the leather quality, tumbled, premium. But these are clean, ladies. Enjoy, right? So the Air Jordan 1 OG High Satin Bread colorway for 2023. It's October the 12th, Throwback Thursday. That's it. Right. So I said I had another sneaker. This is gonna be the Nike release. Hopefully the condition is good. Were decent for the price that I paid. So this was from a seller on eBay. I just saw a skate shop had these restocked yesterday and the day before. I think they only have like a size 4 left. That's the only hint I can give because I may need them later and I know they'll sell out. All you skateboard heads, or sneaker resellers, individuals that just seek the Dunk Low SB. So the eBay seller. So these have been authenticated. Meet your soulmates. eBay authenticity guaranteed. So in other words, when you choose a shoe, whether you're bidding, buy it now, or you've been making offers, and your offer was selected. Sneaker to ensure that it's authentic and nobody stuck you. Part one is check the seller's feedback, right? Read any of the negativity. If it's any neutral or negative responses, take heed to that. Try to find a seller with better feedback or the best that you can. It depends on the location and how quick you want to receive it, depending on the shipping. And really study the pictures and the description, right? Because even if they're authenticated, meaning they're real, they're authentic, they're not fake fugazis or fufus, that doesn't mean that the condition isn't up to your standard. So I experienced that recently with a seller for a friend. They're still upset to this date. And we tried submit a claim. The photos, the angles, the lighting wasn't like it was in person. The outsole was clean, but the upper was beat on some SVs. On the ACG Celadons. The seller, you know who you are. Those angles that you pick, it tricked us. And I've been on eBay for years. But it rolled in your favor. Lesson learned, just took that L. My friend don't even wear his SBs to work. He's so mad about these, he's just wearing them to work daily because they was beat. So, anyway, long rant. So this is the card you get, authentic without a doubt. So we know that so far. The box looks good. That I was talking about, they even shipped them in a different box. I couldn't even upload the video for you guys. I don't think I am, but I do have a video, maybe one day. Comment below if you want to see that video. SB Dunk Low Pro black, white, and black. That's the label that was on the other box for the Cellar Dogs that released like in 2021. Men's 9.5, women's 11. These released in 2022. Nike SB box, purple and white. Gum line, if you're looking for SBs and you're on a budget, the resale for these is going to be your least expensive. That's the Adobe, the black gum, and the white gum. Alright, so I think I paid about 100 and some change. These just came out last year, so some wear on them, but to kick around in and wear, I think I can clean these holes up a little bit better. And definitely clean the white on the swoosh. The stitching for the Nike on the heel is intact, very lightweight by the way. So your Adobes, your black and white gums, which is these, the white gum, then maybe the wheats are going to be your least expensive. Still going to get premium materials. I would probably say above it would be the Wolf Grey gums. It's probably going to be the one that costs the most out of that pack. Puffy Puff Puff Tongue. Your rope laces with Nike on the tips in white. I don't know if these are supposed to come with extra laces. Comment below if you know. You got your elastic straps on the inside for support, padding around the side and on the heel. Yeah, we're gonna get these a little bit more crispy, but this is how they came. The right side toolbox area is in better condition than your left side, which has creasing. Some of you professional restorers and cleaners probably know how to steam this and get it back flat with the iron without damaging the nubuck material. But other than that, light clean should get these back right. Big Dunk Lows, the puffy tongue, it squeals when you squeeze it. Tiger us down, squeal! eBay, authenticity hang tag, scan the back, get the history of the shoe. I still might try to catch these for retail, some kind of way. DS. Hope you enjoyed the video. We got some more SBs on the way. We got the dark gray SB Dunk Low on the way. We got the Jordan 8s on the way. And we also got the SB Dunk Low Barcelonas on the way. So stay tuned. All right. Check out all the previous videos if you get a chance, or most of them. Comment how you feel about these. Let's go. Peace. Peace and love. Yeah.